So COP26 moves into day two, and the hectoring, hypocrisy and virtue signalling continue. But don't worry, there's still another 10 days to go, you lucky people, so there's plenty more to come. Most of the political and media class is convinced the world faces meltdown unless we lower our carbon emissions, reaching so-called net zero by 2050. Meanwhile, millions of ordinary men and women look on at this Glasgow summit and frown. Yes, there is broad understanding and acceptance among the UK population. We should pollute less and pass on a better world to our children and grandchildren. But I'd say the silent majority of British people, ordinary mums and dads, hard-working folk holding down jobs and running small businesses, are thinking, fine, yes, but how much will it cost? And how can I afford an electric car, a heat pump for my house, and ever-spiralling energy bills? How much of the burden of transitioning to this low-carbon, low-emission economy, the COP26 agenda, will fall on me and my family when we're already struggling to make ends meet? Net zero by 2050 isn't just the aim. In this country, it's mandatory. In 2019, Theresa May's government passed legislation requiring the UK to hit that target by law. That means not only reducing our use of fossil fuels like coal, oil and gas, but offsetting the emissions caused by the fossil fuels we do use with so-called carbon capture, tree planting and other carbon reduction strategies. Now, here on The Money, over recent weeks, we've been discussing, with new petrol and diesel vehicles set to be banned by 2030 and gas-fired boilers to be replaced by expensive heat pumps, how much this strategy will cost. Government estimates of the annual bill remain vague and non-committal, and cost concerns among the general public are rising. But it strikes me achieving net zero in a less polluted world isn't so much about pain and sacrifice, it's more about being technologically savvy. It's about renewable technology, harnessing wind and solar in a way that's cost-efficient. It's about battery technology, storing renewable energy so it provides a constant baseload electricity supply that can safely and reliably replace fossil fuels. But the technology that really interests me is the so-called magic molecule, hydrogen, which can be burnt to produce both heat and energy. A recent government strategy paper plans to allow what's called blue hydrogen, made using natural gas or perhaps other fossil fuels. Environmentalists and some investors in hydrogen say that misses the point, and we need instead green hydrogen, produced by splitting water via electrolysis. Electrolysis powered by renewable energy only. If you produce such green hydrogen using renewables, hydrogen which can then power cars, buses, ships and maybe even aeroplanes, then in my view, net zero becomes a real possibility without the pain, sacrifice and chest beating being promoted by the COP26 crowd. So that's our On The Money debate today. Is hydrogen the key to net zero?